We know the team is much bigger than the 15 players. Those guys who work in the front office, they were good people. But the most important part of the process is the players. So for him to say that is offensive to the way that I approach the game.
I wanted these do-it-yourselfers around the house. So I could take Larry out, and he was fascinated by fixing things with his hand, took a lot of pride in it. And Michael would be out, and you'd say, give me a Phillips screwdriver, he might give you a pair of plows, you know. And I guess I was a little short-paced with him. I'd say, get back in the house with your mom. Boy, you're never gonna be anything. Just go back with your mom.
When you're going through it, it's traumatic, you know, because I want that, you know, I want that approval. I want that type of confidence. So my determination got even greater to be as good, if not better, than my brother. Clyde was a threat. You know, I'm not saying he wasn't a threat, but me being compared to him, I took offense to that.
Michael, game on the line, who would take the last shot?
Me.
That's a dumb question.
Me.
I was a little bit upset that I didn't get the MVP that year and they gave it to Charles Barkley. But with that said, okay, fine, you can have that. I'm gonna get this. I knew that Jerry Krause loved Dan Marley. And just because Krause liked him was enough for me. You think he's a great defensive player? Okay, fine. I'm gonna show you that he's not.
I felt like BJ should know better. If you're gonna high five, talk trash, now I had a bone to pick with you.
You know, I'm supposed to kill this guy. You know, I'm supposed to dominate this guy. And from that point on, I did.
During the finals, we go out to dinner one night. George Karl's over on the other side, having dinner. But, hey, there's George Karl over there. And George Karl does not come over and speak to him.
He walked right past me. And I look at him, I say, really? Oh, so that's how you're gonna play it?
You know, he just kind of went by, and I went, uh-oh, should have never done that.
I said, it's a crock of shit. You know, we went to Carolina, we know Dean Smith, you know, I see him in the summer, we play golf. You gonna do this? Okay, fine. That's all I needed. That's all I needed for him to do that, and it became personal with me. If I had to pick a team that gave us the toughest time in the East, you know, Indiana was probably the toughest outside of Detroit. They were tough. Every time I go in that fucking game and come out, I got a new scratch. It became personal with me.
Michael.
What's the biggest motivating factor going into that series for you?
Karl Malone get MVP.
Congratulations, Karl Malone, 1996-97 NBA Most Valuable Player.
Karl Malone was the most valuable player that year, so here was added motivation for Michael, right? He thought he should have been the MVP.
So we knew immediately where this was going.
I'm not saying he wasn't deserving of it. All I'm saying is that fueled the fire in me and said, okay, you think he's the MVP? Okay, fine, no problem. Yeah, Brian Russell. When I was playing baseball, Utah's in town to play the Bulls. They're practicing at the facility. I go over and say hello to John and Carl. And this kid, Brian Russell, comes up to me and said, man, why you quit? Why you quit? Man, you knew I could guard your ass. I couldn't, you had to quit. I said, Carl, you need to talk to this dude, man. No, he's just a young rookie. But from that point on, he's been on my list.